What's going on, YouTube? I welcome you to It's Wild Out Here, the channel bringing you the wildest stories from around the world. And today ain't no different. So hit that like and subscribe button because it's wild out here. And I'm going to tell you all about it. Today's story comes from California. A Los Angeles mother has been charged with the murder of two decapitated children. The mother of two children who were found decapitated in their North Los Angeles home has been charged with murder nearly 1 year after their deaths. Authorities in Arizona arrested 44-year-old Natalie Brothwell on Tuesday in her Tucson home on two counts of murder and two counts of felony child endangerment. The charges stem from the November 2020 killings of her 12-year-old son and 13-year-old daughter in Lancaster, California. Law enforcement officials did not go into detail about Brothwell's alleged involvement in the crimes, but she is the second individual to be arrested in connection to them. The children's father, 35-year-old Maurice Taylor Sr., was charged with each of their murders as well as endangering their younger siblings. Taylor is accused of fatally stabbing his children, Maurice and Malika, on November 29, 2020, the Sunday after Thanksgiving. He allegedly kept the children's bodies in the home for at least 5 days and forced their little brothers, 8 and 9-year-old boys, to stare at the bodies. Both victims were decapitated, and Lancaster Mayor R. Rex Paris described the incident as being pretty brutal. Prosecutors also alleged that the younger children were forced to stay in their rooms for days without food. Some of Taylor's physical therapy clients also reported that he could not be reached for scheduled Zoom appointments in the week leading up to the discovery and contacted authorities. Deputies were called to the family's home on December 4, 2020, after a reported gas leak when they found the children. According to Lieutenant Brandon Dean, the children suffered some type of sharp trauma from either a stabbing or slicing device. Both Taylor and Brothwell, as well as the other children, were found in the home and questioned by police, but only Taylor was arrested. He has an arraignment scheduled for November 10th. Brothwell will remain in custody at the Pima County Jail in Arizona pending extradition to California, the Sheriff's Department said. She is being held on $1 million bond. If convicted, Taylor faces 57 years to life in prison. However, he is not eligible for the death penalty. He's being held on $4.2 million bail. It is not clear if Brothwell would face a similar sentence. The case remains under investigation. This is a wild story, y'all. Let us know what y'all think about these parents in the comments. And like always, stay safe and stay aware. And remember to hit that like and subscribe button, and we'll see you next time on It's Wild Out Here.